Hello, everybody. Welcome to our Zoo View. My name is Rachel Sanchi. We are hanging out with the birds today at the zoo, the Wings of Wonder Bird Show. I'm here with Lauren, and you're here to show us what's going on.
That's right. We have some exciting birds for you guys to meet today because we want you guys to come out to the zoo and come see our Wings of Wonder Bird Show. And that show is awesome because you're going to see birds flying over your heads. You're going to see birds from all over the world as well. And we've got some special stars of the show today for you guys to meet. So our first bird we're going to meet today, her name is Loco. She is a ruby macaw that you'll find in Central and South America. So one of the cool things about macaws is we all know they're great flyers, but she's showing off how well of a climber she is right now. Yeah. They've got specialized feet that are called zygodactyl feet.
Okay.
And it sounds like a dinosaur term, but it actually just means she's got two toes in the front and two toes in the back, which she was just showing off how well she could use those feet to help her eat those seeds that she loves to eat. Now she's making a few flights through our auditorium, which is something you'll get to experience during our Wings of Wonder Bird Show. So like I said, you can feel the wind beneath the wings of those birds. And she's gonna hopefully make a few flights to our trainers here. Macaws have very powerful wings. And they've got an awesome tail as well. So when she's sitting on our trainer's hand, you'll notice that her tail almost looks stacked on one on top of the other. But she actually can use that tail like a rudder on a boat. So use it to steer from side to side if she was going to navigate through trees or even our audience's heads.
Well, what's incredible, as you mentioned, audience's heads. I mean, normally this auditorium is filled with people. She's going right over the top.
That's right. So she'll go right over the top of them and... She will come very close to you, so
watch out.
They are seasoned pros. They love doing this show. They love getting out and getting to stretch their wings, which is a great form of enrichment for our birds here at the bird show as well.
Right. And the color of her, I mean, she's gorgeous.
Yeah, so even though they're called ruby macaws, they have basically every color of the rainbow on them. Yeah. We call them our rainbow macaws as well. So give you guys a nice little wave. Our birds know a lot of different behaviors. It's fun for us to use training to help enrich our birds as well. So we train them to do a lot of natural behaviors to show off some of the things that they would naturally do in the wild. That flying is a great behavior for them to do.
How long does it take you to train a bird like this?
Well, it really depends on the behavior we're asking them to do. A lot of times we will use what's called capturing, which basically just means that it's something the bird's already doing. And when we catch them doing it, we reward that. So you can use that on your dog at home. You can use it on your husband's, your spouse's. If you capture them washing the dishes, we'll give them lots of treats for that. So.
That's incredible. So how old is this bird?
Loco is only 4 years old. So she was actually born right here at the Kansas City Zoo.
Oh.
She was born in the Discovery Zone. So that's another fun area, especially if you have the kids.
Yeah.
To come out, bring them, you can see Loco's parents as well.
Oh my goodness. This is an incredible animal. Any other fun facts about this one, Loco?
Well, that beak on top of her face, it's very large. They actually have between 500 to 700 pounds per square inch. So to put that more in our terms, it takes about 7 pounds per square inch to break a human finger.
Whoa.
So they're incredibly, incredibly strong.
Yeah.
And they are really smart as well. They have the intelligence of about a 2 to 3 year old. So,
wow. Okay.
You know, if you've got toddlers at home, it's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
But imagine a 2 to 3 year old for 60 to 80 years.
Yeah.
Maybe wouldn't be your first pet you would choose. So unfortunately, the pet trade is something that they face in the wild. So we do encourage you guys, if you are going to get a pet at home, to just do your research.
Mm-hmm.
Find the right animal for your family, and the animal and your family will definitely thank you for doing that research.
Right.
But if you guys love macaws just like we do, come see us here at the Wings of Wonder Bird Show, and it's a great chance to get that up-close experience.
So I forgot to mention, obviously, this is a Facebook Live, so send us your questions throughout. We just got a couple of them, so I'm going to ask. Grace asked, how many shows a day?
That's an excellent question. So right now we have 2 shows a day, one at 11:30 and one at 2:30.
Okay.
Each show is completely different. There's different birds. So if you've seen the bird show before, come back and see it again because you never know what animal stars are going to be in it and you never know what experience you'll get to be. So that brings me up to our next bird. It's actually one that we're going to show as one of our volunteer opportunities that we have during our show.
Ooh.
During our shows, we like to keep people engaged. We like to pull up a volunteer every once in a while also.
A brave soul to come down.
A brave soul, that's right. So we're going to be bringing out McKenna. She's one of our animal trainers here at the zoo as well. So she's going to be showing off what our volunteer does. So we'll usually pick an adult volunteer who's very brave. She's got some bird treats already set up in her hand for this. And we're going to be releasing Rocky, who is one of our birds that will come land on our brave volunteer.
So speaking of what she has in her hand, Kim was asking, what is their favorite treat?
It depends on the bird. Rocky here is actually getting bird seed. Loco loves sunflower seeds. So she gets a dry diet. They get fresh fruits and vegetables daily. And then those sunflower seeds are usually what they like to work for the best.
You don't even flinch when they just came over. I was flinching of, oh, goodness, it's going to hit us.
Yeah, Rocky's a little bit of a chaotic flyer, as you saw. But it's a lot of fun because this is an opportunity that most people don't get. And a lot of people don't realize how intelligent rock doves actually are. So they don't have the best reputation. But part of our show is what we're trying to do is get people to really be inspired by these animals. Rock doves are actually used in World War I and World War II to carry messages across enemy lines. And they have excellent navigation skills, which hopefully he'll show off in just a second. But they do have that intelligence that they aren't normally known for.
Mm-hmm. Linda was asking, how long do they live? I believe that was about Loco, the parrot.
Loco can live 60 to 80 years, so quite a long time.
Right.
And
oh my goodness.
Macaws actually grow very, very quickly. All right, we'll see if we'll use those now.
See, I was flinching all over the place, and Lauren was just as cool as a cucumber.
All right, I'll try to send him out.
Okay, she's going to get ready to try to send him out. Jessica was asking about parrots really speaking. I had a question about that, too. When parrots speak, do they know what they're saying, or are they just copying you?
That is an excellent question. So they don't actually know what they're saying. What they're doing is mimicking stuff that they've heard.
Mm-hmm.
They say they have to hear something that's several hundred times to even 1,000 times before they'll actually pick up what they're saying.
Oh.
And so we do have some of our macaws know different words on cue. Some of them, though, they know the words because you'll hear them when you're cleaning and they think you're not paying attention to them and they're having conversations with each other. They know each other's names and all of that. So they know different sounds of like our microwave that's in our room and all of that. Our radio is beeping. So it's pretty hilarious what these birds know and what they've picked up.
Yeah, that's hysterical. Okay, we have one more bird that's coming out. What is this?
That's right. So we're going to bring our East African crowned crane. His name is Cha-Cha, and he's one of our most dynamic stars. We've already met some pretty cool ones, but he's one of our favorites. And he's going to be making his grand entrance right here with Jessica.
Oh, my. Look at that, the hair on the top of his head right there.
That's right. So that beautiful mohawk he has, that's actually modified feathers. And it's really important for East African crowned cranes to have this hairdo because they're going to live in the grasslands of the Serengeti. So imagine those tall, tan grasses would actually blend in quite well. Predators wouldn't even know that they're there.
Yeah.
The Cha-Cha here was actually born in the Africa section of our zoo as well.
Okay.
So if you guys come to the zoo, after you go to the bird show, of course, you can go check out the Sky Safari, where you'll actually see some East African crowned cranes, and you can actually see his parents on the on the Serengeti. Now, he did that impressive flight, and I will tell you, as a bird show trainer, we all know we can't fly, so teaching a bird to fly isn't necessarily the easiest thing. So what we do is we train using modified steps or approximations. So that just means baby steps. So we train him to fly from like a box to a box really close, and we slowly back it up. But he flew up very well, but flying down was a little more difficult because sometimes he didn't want to use the stairs. So lucky for him, we do have an elevator here in the Doremus building, and he became a frequent flyer by elevator. So,
Well, Kelly was asking, how tall do the cranes get?
He's probably about 4 foot tall, so he is adult size at being at 5 years of age. And you can hear how loud those wings are. So he's got those impressive wings that he'll use. That wingspan is probably about 4.5 foot wide. So wingspan is from tip to tip, as he's showing off there.
Wow.
Now, he does not have to be a quiet flyer.
Okay.
Because what he's going to be looking for are things such as insects in the wild, so you don't really have to sneak up on those.
Right.
But what he's going to be needing that wingspan for is to travel miles and miles and miles. Now, if he flies up again, you may notice that he doesn't really pull his legs up all the way.
Yeah.
If he was to be flying like miles and miles, he would pull all that landing gear up. But here at the bird show, one of the fun things that Cha-Cha flies during your experience here is sometimes his legs droop down a little bit, so he may take off a hat or a pair of sunglasses every once in a while.
Yeah. Mabel was asking, how many different bird species do you have at the zoo and the show?
We have We have several different types of birds. We have macaws. We've got a bunch of raptors like red-tailed hawks, African fish eagle, southern ground hornbill, smaller parrots as well. So there's a wide variety of birds in our bird show.
Oh my goodness, he's getting closer.
He's checking out everything. He's a very curious bird as well. And he was actually hand-raised by some of our trainers when he was a baby.
He puts off a lot of wind there, too, with that big wingspan.
That's right.
Okay, Aniston was asking, what is your favorite bird to work with?
Well, man, that's a hard question because you all like them all for different reasons. I would say Steve, our southern ground hornbill, which is another bird that you've got to come see at our Wings of Wonder Bird Show. He's such an impressive bird to come out here. But Cha-Cha is definitely a close second favorite. But yeah, you've got to come out here and check out the Wings of Wonder Bird Show.
Okay, Cha-Cha is his name. Matt was asking who names the birds.
It depends, but generally our trainers name our birds. So usually when you're hand raising them, you're putting in a lot of time and dedication. So we try to have it where a lot of times our trainers name our birds. Although lately we've been doing a few naming contests for our animals as well. So that's always a fun thing. So if you follow us on Facebook, sometimes you'll see some of our baby animals. We'll have a naming contest, and it's a great time for the guests to get involved with that.
Yeah, definitely. Avery was asking, and this is a good question. You kind of touched on it earlier, but are birds smarter than we give them credit for? I mean, they have a lot of training here.
I would say they are definitely a lot smarter than we give them credit for. Everything from our macaws to even our rock dove that we met earlier, they've all got to be incredibly smart to help survive in their environment. So the different adaptations and the different intelligence levels that they each have is truly incredible and something you can definitely check out.
It kind of looks like he's poking around up there on that box. What's he doing?
So when he flew up to the box, he got his reinforcement. So he's getting crane grain, which is one of his favorite snacks.
Oh, yep.
So he's eating a few of those. And the way they eat is kind of like stabbing at something with that little beak of his. So.
Okay, I saw this bird earlier, and I mentioned to Vic, who's our photographer today, it kind of reminds me of the bird that you see in the child's movie of Up.
Yeah, he looks a lot like Kevin does.
Yeah.
So those nice long legs, that long neck that he has. And a lot of times those cartoon animals are stuff that they'll take different adaptations, different features, and turn them into a Disney animal. That noise he makes actually kind of is very similar to what a peacock makes. So a lot of times different sounds that different animals make in the movies is a really cool thing too. I recently read, if you guys follow Jurassic World, that the red-tailed hawk makes a very shrill call, and that's usually what they use for velociraptors. So nice fun movie fact for you.
Okay, so Emmy asked, do you have raptors in the show? I think you mentioned this.
That's right. We do usually have several raptors in each show, depending on the theme of our show. So you can see anything from a Harris's hawk, which is a hawk you'll find in southwest United States, our red-tailed hawks. We've got an African fish eagle and even a subarctic great horned owl, which is incredible to see as well.
Yeah, that's amazing. Okay, last one. Where are the cranes native to?
They are native to East Africa, so you're going to find them in that Serengeti region. You'll usually find them in big groups, though. Mm-hmm. So,
yeah.
Big family.
Well,
animals.
This has been absolutely incredible to see all of these amazing birds. So, again, thank you so much, Lauren. They have two shows a day, and where can you get tickets?
It's actually included in the price of your zoo ticket. So another reason to come see the Wings of Wonder Bird Show, 11:30 and 2:30 every single day.
All right, Wings of Wonder, live at Zoo View. I'm Rachel Sanchi. Thanks to y'all for watching.
How cool.
Yeah, it was fun, wasn't it?
Yeah.